Hello students, welcome to Rajesh Biology. This is Rajesh, MSc Zoology. Today I am going to give lecture about Periplaneta americana respiratory system of cockroach, because it is very important for IB and NEET also for first year students. There is IB examination in March, so it is very important. LAQ question. So come to the topic. It is very easy to learn and to write. The diagram also very easy. I will teach you how to draw the diagram of respiratory system of cockroach. It is somewhat confusion when we see it. Come to respiratory system. First, want to give you some definition, like introduction of respiratory system of cockroach. Generally, we have blood, and our blood cells have hemoglobin, and the hemoglobin is act as a carrier or a respiratory pigment for oxygen. But due to the absence of hemoglobin, the blood of cockroach is white in color. And due to the absence of hemoglobin, the blood doesn't play any role in respiration. So the cockroach, or most of the insects, develop a specialized tracheal system for respiration. First, the cockroach blood doesn't have hemoglobin, so it doesn't play any role in respiration. It develops a special tracheal system for do the respiratory activity. Tracheal system includes three main parts. Spiracles or stigmata, and trachea, tracheoles. These are the three main parts present in respiratory system of cockroach. Only three parts: spiracles, trachea, and tracheoles. Very easy. First, spiracles or stigmata. Spiracles are like our external nostrils. We have two spiracles like this. So cockroach have 10 pairs of spiracles. First, how many? 10 pairs. Where they are located? They are located in pleura of cockroach. That means if it is cockroach, it is dorsal tegu, and it is ventral sternum. Okay, and there is a head right angles to the body, hypoglottis head. Okay, and the edges is known as pleura. The spiracles or tracheal system, openings of tracheal system, are present in pleura, lateral pleura, like this. It is a spiracle. The spiracles are open at the lateral side, and it is another spiracle, and it is another spiracle. These are the spiracles. They present at lateral pleura. This type of spiracles are there. 10 pairs of spiracles. This side 10, this side 10. 10 pairs. And in the 10 pairs, 2 pairs present in thorax. And the remaining 8 pairs present in abdomen. If it is cockroach, for example, this is a rough diagram. The portion, it is thorax. 2 pairs present in thorax region, and the remaining 8 pairs present in abdominal region. So these are the spiracles. These about the spiracles. Okay. Respiratory system have 3 main parts: spiracles, trachea, and tracheoles. Spiracles. 10 pairs of spiracles are there. They are present in lateral pleura. In the 10 pairs, 2 pairs present in thorax region,
8 pairs present in abdominal region. Clear? And there are two words, polymnestic. Poly means many. If any insect have more than 3 pairs of spicules, the condition is known as polymnestic. Poly means many, mnestic means spicules. There are 10 pairs, so cockroach is a polymnestic. And holomnestic. If all spicules are working in condition, that condition is known as a holomnestic. Holo means complete, entire, all spicules are working. So cockroach have 10 pairs of spicules, more than 3, so it is a polymnestic. And all spicules are working, so it is holomnestic. 10 pairs of spicules, 2 pairs present in thorax, 8 pairs present in abdomen. Clear? And the spiracle structure is like this. Spiracle is an external opening and it is covered by a ring known as peritrin. It is a peritrin. Peri means around. Around the spiracle, so peritrin. And there are hair-like structure known as trichomes. It is peritrin. If you draw the diagram with labels, you can easily learn and you can easily revise during examinations. Trichomes. It is a spiracle. And it opens into a chamber known as atrium. Is opened into a chamber known as atrium. From the atrium, tracheal tubes are raised. We will discuss later. So it is about spirals. Simple. Respiratory system of cockroach. Due to the absence of hemoglobin, blood doesn't play any role in respiration. So it develops a special tracheal system for respiration. And the tracheal system has three main parts. First one, spiracles. They are also known as the stigmata. And these are the external openings of tracheal system, like nostrils. And we also have a peritrin-like structure, cartilage. And we also have hair-like structure, trichomes, right? And 10 pairs of spirals are there. In the 10 pairs, 2 pairs present in thorax region and 8 pairs present in abdominal region. Each spiracle is surrounded by a peritrin. It is a ring-like structure. And the spiracles have hair-like structures known as trichomes. And the spiracles are open into a chamber known as atrium. This is about spiracles. Come to the trachea. Wait. Trachea. I will draw the diagram of respiratory system of cockroach. It is very easy how to draw. So many members feel confusion when drawing the diagram, when how it is taught. First, draw the head portion. And it is thorax region. And then next, abdominal region. Thorax region have three segments. First, draw the three segments with the correct positions. And very slight lines or dots. That is the way how to draw the thorax region. Okay, first segment, prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. The remaining 8 abdominal, 10 abdominal segments. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Sorry. I'll draw very small segments here, so I'll draw again later. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
8, 9, 10. Like this only. After that, you can erase the middle lines. First, the trachea of thorax region. First two spiracles are present, first two pairs of spiracles are present in mesothorax and metathorax. That means prothorax doesn't have any spiracles. Okay, the spiracles are present in mesothorax and metathorax. Each spiracle open into a chamber known as atrium, like this. That means like this. And it is surrounded by a peritoneum and it has trichomes. This is the structure. And thoracic spiracles open into a chamber known as atrium. From the atrial chamber of thoracic spiracles, several horizontal trachea run inside. So they are like this. Several horizontal trachea run inside and they join together to form dorsal cephalic trunks. And from ventral side also, it is ventral side, we have to imagine. That means it is dorsal side. Just behind the dorsal side, there is another tracheal tube run inside horizontally and they also join together. To form ventral cephalic trunks. Like this. From this also. You can use multiple colors when drawing this diagram. In examination also you can use three types of color pens. Blue, black, red. Red also you can use and pencil. So this is the way how to draw the thoracic trachea. So simply, the atriums of thoracic spiracles gives rise to horizontal tracheal tubes. That horizontal tracheal tubes run inside and join together to meet dorsal and ventral cephalic trunks. Cephalic means head. That why we also learn like this, cephalization. Concentration of sensory cells and nerve cells at the anterior end is known as cephalization. And you learn like this also in crustaceum. In the case of prawn, the head region and the thorax region unite to form cephalothoracic region, cephalothorax region. Okay, so which is called by Arabic. So this is cephalic region. So the trunks are known as cephalic trunks, dorsal cephalic trunks and ventral cephalic trunks. They give their branches to the head sinus. This is about thoracic spiracles. Come to the abdominal spiracles. The 8 abdominal spiracles are present in first 8 abdominal segments. That's why 9th and 10th segment doesn't have any spiracles. Clear? Come to abdominal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is 9th, this is 10th. My diagram may be wrong. Okay. So this is the first 8 abdominal spiracles. Each segment have opening known as spiracle. And each spiracle opens into a chamber known as atrium. When come to the abdominal spiracles, atrium of abdominal spiracles, it gives longitudinal trachea. There are three longitudinal tracheal trunks are there. It is dorsal longitudinal trunk. It is dorsal longitudinal trunk. From this side also it has
a dorsal longitudinal trunk. Red color is dorsal, blue color is ventral for this diagram. Very easy. Okay, and from each spiracle, ventral tubes also there is. Like this, very easy to draw. You can erase this central black color lines, then it will appear. A complete clear ending is help to impress the image later. So this is a longitudinal, ventral longitudinal tracheal trunk. These are the dorsal longitudinal trunks. There is another longitudinal tracheal trunk known as lateral longitudinal, which is long, it is very long, and compared with the remaining two tracheal trunks. So, this is spiracle. Spiracle is covered by peritrium and they also have trichomes, but spiracle open intake called chamber called known as atrium, and from each atrium there is a tracheal tube arise. If it is a spiracle of thoracic region, it gives horizontal trachea. If it is a spiracle of abdominal region, first it opens with a tracheal horizontal tracheal tube, and tracheal tube opens into a longitudinal tracheal trunk like this. If it is present on dorsal side, it is dorsal tracheal trunk, dorsal longitudinal tracheal trunk. If it is present in ventral, from this atrium, ventral also arises. That ventral also open into like this. On ventral side, from this atrium, a lateral longitudinal trunk also arise like this. This is the opening of ventral longitudinal tracheal trunk. This is the opening of dorsal longitudinal tracheal trunk. This is the opening of lateral longitudinal tracheal trunk. There are three tracheal trunks. For example, my body is lateral longitudinal tracheal trunk, and in black color t-shirt I have. Okay, it is a lateral longitudinal tracheal trunk. This is red marker, it is a dorsal longitudinal tracheal trunk. And this is blue color, it is a ventral longitudinal tracheal trunk. There are three tracheal trunks present in your right side. As like that, in left side also there is three longitudinal tracheal trunks. The tracheal trunks of both sides are communicate with one another by commissural trachea. The longitudinal tracheal trunks of both sides are connected by commissural trachea. Commissure means a bridge. For example, in our brain also we have a commissure, a myelinated fibers which attaches, which which are helpful in communicating between the two cerebral hemispheres, is known as corpus callosum. Corpus callosum is a commissure which connects both cerebral hemispheres. Here also, these are the commissural trachea. Commissural trachea are the trachea which connects the both sides longitudinal tracheal trunks. So this is about commissural trachea. Alright? And come to the structure of trachea. Structure of trachea have three layers. Outermost basement membrane. Outermost basement membrane. And epithelial layer. Second layer is epithelial layer. And third one is intima. It is intima. There are three layers in trachea structure. Trachea have three layers: outermost basement membrane, and middle epithelial layer, and innermost intima. Intima secretes spiral thickenings. Spiral thickenings called tenidia. Tenidia, basement membrane, epithelial layer, and intima. These are the three layers. And tenidia helps to prevent the collapsing of trachea. For example, it is a water tube. Water moves very forcefully. When any car or when any vehicle are move on this pipe, what will happen? The pipe will collapse. The pipe will come to the like the pipe come to like this. So air cannot pass through the trachea. Air cannot pass through the trachea. So what will happen here? A spiral thickening prevents the collapsing of trachea. For example, it will appear like a refill pen. Refill is a air, and there is a spring around the pen. That spring is known as tenidia, and on the spring tenidia there is a intima. That intima is inner layer of the pen, and this blue color is outer covering, and the red color is grip. So this is a pen. Okay, tick tick pen or not. Alright. So each trachea ends in a specialized cell. Each trachea ends in a specialized cell known as tracheoblast. Known as a tracheoblast. Clear? So I'll repeat the trachea. The spiracles of thoracic region gives several horizontal trachea, and they run inside and meet together or join together to form dorsal and ventral cephalic trunks. Clear? And abdominal region, there are 8 pairs of spiracles. They give rise to tracheal tubes which open into longitudinal tracheal trunks, dorsal, ventral, and lateral longitudinal trunks. Lateral longitudinal trunks are the longest tracheal trunks. Okay, the longitudinal tracheal trunks of both sides are communicate with commissural trachea. And trachea gives their branches into different organs. When come to the structure of trachea, trachea have three layers: the outermost basement membrane, and the middle epithelium layer, and the inner intima. Intima have capacity to secrete some spiral structure. That spiral thickenings are known as tenidia. The spiral thickenings are known as tenidia, which prevents the collapsing of trachea, and which allow the free passage of air. And each tracheal branch ends in a specialized cell known as tracheoblast. Okay, now tracheoles. Before going to tracheoles, we will repeat now. Spiracles are 10 pairs. They present in lateral pleura, 2 pairs in thorax, 8 pairs in abdomen, polyneuristic and holoneuristic. Okay, and they give rise to tracheal branches. Thoracic tracheal branches are horizontal in nature. Abdominal tracheal branches are longitudinal nature. Both sides of longitudinal trachea connected with commissural trachea, and trachea have three layers: basement, epithelium, and intima. Intima secretes septinidia, which prevents the collapsing of trachea, and trachea opens into a special cell called tracheoblast. From the tracheoblast, a very fine branches are arise. Very fine branches arise. These branches are made with protein trichin, so they are known as tracheoles. And these tracheal branches have intimate association with the mitochondria of each cell. That means they can enter into each cell. They have an intimate association with mitochondria. And these tracheoles are filled with a fluid known as tracheolar fluid. The fluid name is tracheolar fluid. These are filled with a special fluid structure known as tracheolar fluid. And what is the importance of the tracheolar fluid? When insect is very active, when insect is moving or when insect is walking, flying, that tracheolar fluid completely absorbed into the mitochondria. That means it will empty. The tracheolar fluid completely absorbed into the cells. When insect is in resting position and it is sleep, in resting position, the tracheolar fluid come back to the tracheoles. And there is no gaseous exchange up to cellular level. So insects are very active. When come to human beings, gaseous exchange occur at two places, at the alveolar site and the at cellular site also. From the alveoli, the oxygen enter into the blood and binds with hemoglobin. From there, that hemoglobin brings that oxygen to the tissues and gives that oxygen into the cell. But here, from the external openings, from the spiracles up to the cellular level, up to the tracheolar level, there is no gaseous exchange. So it has direct contact with atmospheric air. So insects are very active. When insect is very active, the tracheolar fluid is completely absorbed into the cell. When insect is in resting position, it comes back to its normal position. This is about tracheoles. Very easy. And mechanism of respiration also I want to tell you for 2 points for the examination. It is very helpful to get good marks, good impression also. Inspiration and expiration. Inspiration is taking air into the body is known as inspiration, and sending air out of the body is known as expiration. Taking air into the body is known as inspiration, and sending air out of the body, from the body, is known as expiration. During inspiration, thoracic spiracles are open. During inspiration, thoracic spiracles are open, abdominal spiracles are closed. Got it? During expiration, abdominal spiracles are open, thoracic spiracles are closed. Is there any confusion? So, if you feel confusion at this point, I'll give some suggestion to remember this point, but it is not true, but I'll give some suggestion to remember. Cockroach have an internal urge to expel carbon dioxide, to send out that carbon dioxide, which is not useful and which is an excretory product. But it doesn't have any interest to take oxygen. It will come and it will go. It doesn't concern the entry and the outgoing of the oxygen, but it concerned with the, it has an internal urge to forcefully expel the carbon dioxide out. For that purpose, it receives oxygen very little. That's why only two spiracles are open. Only two spiracles. to take oxygen, but it has an internal urge to send that entire carbon dioxide out. So more and more spikes are open during expiration. So abdominal spikes are open during expiration, and these two are closed. During inspiration, only two spikes are open, but the remaining all spikes are closed because it doesn't have any interest to take oxygen, but it has an interest and it has an urge to expel carbon dioxide. Like this way, inspiration is a passive process, but expiration is an active process. It gives some pressure to expel the air, but it doesn't do any work to the air into the body. Okay, so there is no importance for oxygen, but it gives most important for carbon dioxide. This is about the respiratory system of cockroach. What I tell about this spiracle opening and closing is very wrong, but it helpful to remember these points. Can I recall it? Spiracles and trachea, tracheos. First of all, there is no hemoglobin, so it doesn't play any role in respiration. And for that purpose, it develops a special tracheal system. Tracheal system have three main parts: spiracles, trachea, and tracheoles. Spiracles are 10 pairs. They present in thoracic and abdominal region, 2 pairs thorax and 8 pairs abdomen. And they open into atrium. Atrium gives rise to several trachea. If it is present in thorax, it is horizontal trachea. If these spiracles are present in abdomen, these are longitudinal trachea. Both longitudinal trachea from the both sides are connected with commissural trachea. And trachea have three layers: basement, epithelium, and intima. BEI. Basement, epithelium, and intima. BEI. And intima gives expiratory thickness cutaneidia, which allow the free passage of air. And they open into a tracheolar cell, tracheoblast. So, blast means it gives something. Tracheoblast gives tracheoles, which are made up of trachea, and they fill it with trachealar fluid. The trachealar fluid is empty when it is in active position, and it will come back to its normal position when insect is resting. Okay, tracheolars have direct contact with the mitochondria. This is about respiratory system of cockroach. I hope you understand. If there is any doubt, please put comment in comment box. Thank you.